I'm Henny Espinosa, and this is your TFC News Now.
Boats aren't gonna be able to get to him.
Nope. Take my light.
Ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three, yeah.
Migrants crossing the U.S.-Mexico border continue night and day, despite placements of barriers, a wall, and National Guard troops. A Court of Appeals judge is scheduled to hear arguments on Wednesday and decide if Texas Senate Bill 4 violates the U.S. Constitution. SB 4 would authorize police to arrest and detain migrants suspected of illegally crossing the border from Mexico.
America is always welcoming to those people who want to go here for a quote and unquote American dream, but you need to do and you need to follow the law.
Joseph Modesto, a Filipino who lives in the border town of Brownsville, Texas, says he's personally seen the desperate situation of some migrants.
One time I crossed the border and I saw tons of people just lying on the floor, and you can really so concerned about them, because I don't know how are they going to leave like that kind of situation.
Meanwhile, according to Associated Press NORC poll conducted in March, 64% of overall responders, including 54% of Democrats, say they favor hiring more Border Patrol agents as migrant surges persist at the U.S.-Mexico border.
So I never bet on baseball.
In other news, Filipino-Japanese-American Will Ayrton has stepped up to the plate to become baseball superstar Shohei Ohtani's new interpreter. In the wake of illegal betting and accusations of massive theft by Ohtani's former interpreter, Ippei Mizuhara. Considered as an elite two-way player, Ohtani, a two-time American League Most Valuable Player, is the Los Angeles Dodgers pitcher and designated hitter. The 35-year-old Ayrton, on the other hand, has been a Dodgers employee for 9 consecutive seasons in various roles. The Tokyo-born Ayrton is a Japanese-American father and a Filipino mother. His family moved to Hawaii when he was 15, where he played baseball in high school. He also played for the Philippines in the country's bid to qualify for the 2012 World Baseball Classic. Still in sports, Filipino-American saber fencer Mitchell Saron is gearing up to represent the United States at his first ever Olympic Games this summer in Paris, France. USA Fencing confirmed his qualification for both the men's saber individual and team categories at the 2024 Paris Olympics, pending final approval by the U.S. Olympic and Paralympic committees. The 23-year-old Harvard University fencer started fencing at the age of 9 in his hometown of Ridgewood, New Jersey. Saron has won international and national fencing tournaments, including the team gold medal at the Men's Saber World Cup in Budapest in March. On his Instagram page, Saron said his journey has been nothing short of incredible, and that it's a dream come true for him to represent his country on such a grand stage.
And those are the news-making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Stay with us, Kapamilya.